have discussed about this control of fire damp emission, control of fire damp emission, because you know that in coal mines there is methane emission is there. Methane is emitted from the coal seams in coal mines, and this methane emission is the root cause of your methane explosion in the coal mines. So in coal mines, some seams with high methane content at a great depth should be intensively worked by high production method. So if there is methane gas in the coal seam, then you should adopt higher production methods, high production technology, so that quickly you can mine the deposit. And you can also adopt methane drainage techniques to be applied where it is not possible to control methane concentration by adopting the general ventilation system. By adopting the general ventilating system, if you are not able to control the methane emission, then you have to go for methane drainage. So now we'll move to the next class. Now we'll go to the next class, which is on coal dust explosion. We have discussed earlier that there are two types of explosions take place in the mines, coal mines. One is methane explosion, the other one is coal dust explosion. So what is coal dust explosion? We have discussed to some extent. So this coal dust, when it is suspended in the mine air as a cloud of coal dust, is capable of bursting into an explosion. And this, after explosion, it will propagate even in the absence of the fire damp. Even if it is fire damp is not there, methane is not there, if the coal dust is going to be exploded, then the explosion flame will propagate from one area of the mine to the other area. So that is why for a coal dust explosion to take place, these are the conditions to be fulfilled for the coal dust explosion to take place. Coal dust must be of a composition which includes sufficient volatile matter should be there. In the coal dust, sufficient volatile matter should be there. Coal dust should be of necessary fineness. We have discussed earlier that the particle size should be less than 420 micron, and they should be in a dispersible condition. The coal dust should be dispersed in the mine atmosphere in the form of a thick cloud. Then only the coal dust explosion is going to take place. The dust cloud should be so dense that one cannot see even through it. So the dust cloud should be very thick so that you cannot see anything through the coal dust. The quantity amounts to 30 to 40 gram per cubic meter. There should be at least 30 to 40 gram of coal dust per cubic meter of area. A source of ignition should be there with sufficient intensity, then only the coal dust explosion is going to take place. Without ignition, there will be no explosion. We have discussed the explosion pentagon. In the pentagon, fire triangle, we have discussed three things are necessary for the fire to take place. One is your fuel, oxygen, and your ignition or heat. Okay, so there should be an ignition source for the dust cloud to be ignited. Such circumstances generally exist after a fire damp explosion. If there is methane gas in your mine and fire damp explosion has taken place, methane explosion has taken place, then after the explosion, it will ignite. It will ignite the coal dust. If coal dust is present, so after the fire damp explosion, it will ignite the coal dust and there will be coal dust explosion. So fire damp explosion will be followed by the coal dust explosion. So therefore, what is the mechanism of coal dust explosion? So there are certain common views are there or theories are there to explain the mechanism of coal dust explosion. So the common theory is that surface oxidation of coal dust particles. If the coal dust particles are oxidized on their surface, then there will be explosion. And there should be ignition of flammable mixture of air and gases. So if there is methane gas is there, if oxygen is there in the mine atmosphere, at a particular mixture, they become flammable and it can be ignited easily. So ignition of flammable mixture of air and gases present in between the dust particles. Combustion of solid coal particles. Sometimes the solid coal particles also they get ignited if there is a igniting source is there. So these are some of the common views or theories regarding your dust explosion, coal dust explosion. So what is coal dust explosion develops in stages? There are certain stages of coal dust explosion. First, there will be a puff, P-U-F-F, first stage of ignition or puff. What is first stage of ignition? It is a sudden combustion process of a part or whole of airborne dust marked by a very high temperature, but without any dynamic effects. If the whole of the dust is consumed, if the entire dust is consumed, the combustion of dust air mixture ends with a poof. Okay. So see, the coal dust explosion initially, if all the coal dust is consumed during the explosion, then you'll get a poof. Okay.
So then
your mine explosion, if the whole of the dust is not consumed, the poof may lead eventually to an intense explosion. So during the transition from poof to explosion, due to transfer of heat of combustion to the surrounding unburnt layers, mainly by radiation, an increase of pressure in the burning layers takes place. So that is why when the pressure exceeds a certain value, a full-fledged explosion is developed in which the combustion takes place at a rapid rate. So whenever there is an explosion, pressure waves are developed, and these pressure waves developed passes through the unburnt layers ahead of explosion flame and stir up the deposited dust. Whatever dust is there deposited on the surface, they will be stirred up, creating necessary fuel in the form of a thick cloud for the following flame. So flame will ignite the thick cloud of coal dust. Thus the dispersion of dust and flame propagation processes are intercoupled. They are interrelated to each other. So we have seen that there are explosive limits of coal dust. Lower explosive limit, upper explosive limit of coal dust. What is flammability or explosive limits of coal dust? It is defined as its ability of coal dust when in the form of a cloud to spread or propagate ignition to all points. Where dust or dust air mixtures of corresponding concentrations are present. So the flammability limit, explosive limit of coal dust is defined as its ability of the coal dust when they present in the form of a cloud, coal dust cloud, which can spread or which can propagate ignition to all points. Where dust air mixtures of corresponding concentration are present. So what is the range of flammable limits or explosive limits, which varies widely, much wider than in the case of fire damp mixture. Okay. So there are two limits are there, lower flammability limit, upper flammability limit. So this lower flammability is not an absolute quantity. It depends on the following characteristics of the dust. So lower limit of flammability of the coal dust depends upon its particle size. What is the size of the coal dust particles? The chemical composition of the dust. How, what are the chemicals, elements present in the coal dust? What is the nature and intensity of igniting source? So the coal dust explosion is going to take place if there is an igniting source. Ignition source is there. So if there is an igniting source, what is its nature and what is its intensity of the igniting source? Then time of contact with the source. Time of contact with the source. Then turbulence of the dust cloud. The dust cloud, whether they are deposited on the surface or they are in movement in the atmosphere. Turbulence of the coal dust cloud, the uniformity of dust suppression, dispersion, whether the dust is dispersed uniformly throughout the mine galleries or they are not uniformly distributed. Then what is the purity of this sample? The coal dust, along with coal dust, any other material is present or not? What is the purity of this sample? And composition of the atmosphere. What is the percentage of oxygen, nitrogen, other gases, carbon dioxide, especially methane and oxygen content in the mine atmosphere? These are the characteristics which are necessary for determining the lower limit of flammability of the coal dust. So in the case of bituminous coals, the lower flammability limit varies widely between 30 to 300 gram per cubic meter. Most violent explosions are produced when the concentration is about 10 times the lower limit. So you'll get a very violent explosion if the concentration is about 10 times the lower limit of concentration. And next is your ignition of coal dust air mixture. We have seen that in the explosion pentagon, ignition source, heating, ignition source is very important to ignite the coal dust. So ignition of coal dust air mixture is not so rapid as with the gas air mixture. If it is a methane gas or air mixture is there, methane gas air mixture is there, it will be ignited so easily. But in the case of coal dust air mixture, the ignition is not so rapid. A large source of heat is required for coal dust air mixture to be ignited. So to ignite the coal dust cloud, coal dust air mixture, you need a large source of heat, igniting source. Okay, so the ignition temperature, what is the ignition temperature of coal dust? The ignition temperature of coal dust cloud depends on the rank of the coal, what type of coal you are going to mine, whether it is A class coal or B class coal or F class or E class coal, what is the rank of the coal, high grade coal or low grade coal or cooking coal, what type of coal you are going to mine, or the rank of the coal. The ignition temperature is dependent on the rank of the coal. The ignition temperature decreases as the rank of coal decreases from the anthracites to bituminous coals. So the ignition temperature decreases as the rank of coal also decreases. Anthracite is the very high grade coal, and sub bituminous coal is the low grade coal. So from the high grade coal to the low grade coal, while you are moving, so the ignition temperature also decreases from the high grade coal to the low grade coal. Then this ignition temperature is also depends on the nature and intensity of ignition source. We have seen that there are various type of ignition sources are there. So what is the nature of the ignition source? What is the intensity of the ignition source? Depending on that, the ignition temperature depends. It varies between 900 degree centigrade to 600 degree centigrade for relatively low ash coals. Then next characteristic is your particle size. We have seen that the particles lesser than 420 micron size are called explosive particles. So the ignition temperature is dependent on the particle size also. Then the ignition temperature also depends on the moisture and ash content of the coal or the coal dust particles. What is the moisture content of the coal dust particles? What is the ash content in the coal dust cloud? So depending on the moisture content and the ash content in the coal dust cloud, the ignition temperature is influenced by it. And moisture in the dust particles, moisture in dust particles and in surrounding atmospheres raises the ignition temperature of the dust because of heat absorption and vaporization of the moisture. Okay, so therefore if the coal dust particles are laden with moisture, and for that reason the ignition temperature you need will be more. Moisture in dust particles and in surrounding atmospheres raises the ignition temperature of the dust because of heat absorption and vaporization of the moisture. Then your oxygen concentration in the mine atmosphere, the ignition temperature is also depends on the oxygen concentration in the mine atmosphere, because you need oxygen for oxidation to take place, you need oxygen. So with in decrease in oxygen concentration, if the oxygen concentration is less, you need ignition temperature more. You need more ignition temperature. That is the relationship between the oxygen concentration in the mine atmosphere and the ignition temperature. So there are certain factors are there which affect development of coal dust explosion. These are the factors. These are the factors affecting development of coal dust explosion. What are the factors which affect the development of coal dust explosion. The flammability or explosibility of coal dust air mixtures had been the subject of many investigations carried out in the laboratories, on the surface experimental galleries and experimental coal mines. So, the flammability or explosibility of coal dust air mixture is being examined, investigated in the laboratories, on the surface experimental galleries or in the coal mines itself. So the experimental work was centered around the origin, propagation, control of coal dust explosion. Origin of coal dust explosion, propagation of coal dust explosion, control of coal dust explosion. So there are certain factors which affect the flammability or explosibility of coal dust air mixtures. So all the coal dust is not going to be exploded. There are certain factors which control the flammability or explosibility of coal dust air mixture. First one is the particle size. We have seen that the particle size should be less than 420 micron size. Then only the dust particles will be explosive in nature because of large surface area. Then dustiness of mine workings. The mine working, dust should be present in the mine working, then only explosion is going to take place. If your mine is very clean mine, there is no dust, so no explosion will take place. That is why your aim is to develop a very clean mining environment, free from dust particles. So if the atmosphere is free from dust particles, there will be no explosion in your mines. And flammability or explosibility of coal dust air mixture also depends on the volatile matter content. In the coal dust particles, how much volatile matter is there? That is very important to know the flammability or explosibility of coal dust air mixture. Then how much is the ash present in the coal dust air mixture? Percentage of ash present in the coal dust air mixture. Percentage of moisture. What is the moisture percentage in the coal dust air mixture? What is oxygen concentration in the mine atmosphere or in the coal dust air mixture? Then what is the nature and intensity of ignition source? What is the presence of fire damp in the mine air? Whether methane is present in the mine air or not? Turbulence, whether the coal dust cloud is fixed or they are in motion? Surrounding mine condition. So these are the factors which affect the explosibility of coal dust air mixture. So let us discuss about particle size. So the finer the dust particles, the greater its surface area. We have seen earlier that if the dust particles are very fine in nature, their surface area becomes more per unit mass, and as a result, they become more flammable. Greater is its inflammability. So coal dust particles up to 750 to 1000 micron size take part in explosions, depending upon the rank of the coal, nature and intensity of the ignition source, and the oxygen concentration in the mine atmosphere. We have seen that the particle size should be less than 420 micron for the dust particles to become explosive mixture. But sometimes, even if the coal dust particles are bigger in size, ranging from 750 micron to 1000 micron, they can also take part in explosion, depending upon the rank of the coal, depending upon the nature and intensity of the ignition source, depending upon the oxygen concentration in the mine atmosphere. So, most dangerous particles are 10 to 100 micron if the particle size of the coal dust are in between 10 to 100 micron size, then they are very, very dangerous particles. From the coal dust explosion point of view, if the dust particles are 10 micron to 100 micron size, so they become very dangerous. Dangerous type of explosion may take place. Below 10 micron size, if the dust particles are less than 10 micron size, flammability reduces to a certain degree. Why? Because the chemical composition of the coal dust, due to chemical composition of the coal dust, due to tendency to agglomerate, if the particles are very, very small, fine particles, less than 10 micron size, they may agglomerate. Their tendency is to get agglomerated, and rapid oxidation on initial exposure to air, thereby becoming less easily ignitable. Rapid oxidation, because of the lesser size particle, they become more quickly oxidation takes place, and on initial exposure to air, thereby becoming less easily ignitable. So, what is dustiness of mine workings? You know that in coal mines or in metal mines or in any open cast mine, you go to any mine, you will find a lot of dust in the mine atmosphere. So that is called your dustiness of mine workings, because where from these dusts are coming? You are drilling, you are blasting, you are loading, you are transporting the minerals. So as a result, lot of dust particles are produced in the mines. So if it is a coal mine, you are going to produce a lot of coal dust particles. So the dust cloud, the coal dust cloud, must be dense immediately surrounding the ignition source. If there is an ignition source is there, for example, there is an electrical apparatus is there, from where the sparks are generated. So surrounding this equipment, electrical equipment, where sparks are produced, if there is a dust cloud is there, coal dust cloud is there, immediately surrounding the electrical equipment from where the sparks are coming out, that will ignite the coal dust particles. See, the dust cloud must be dense, immediately surrounding the ignition source, so that one cannot see through it. So the dust cloud should be very thick. Nobody can see through visibility will be very poor if there is a very thick dust cloud in there. So that is called a dustiness of coal mine workings. And minimum density of cloud, dust cloud, which will propagate an explosion, depends on the nature of the ignition source, fineness of the dust particles, and rank of the coal. So the minimum density of coal dust cloud, which will propagate the flame after explosion, it depends on the nature of the igniting source and the fineness of the dust particles and the rank of the coal. So a mine working is dangerously dusty if it contains 100 to 120 gram per cubic meter of dust. Suppose in a mine atmosphere, there is 100 to 120 gram of coal dust is there in every cubic meter of mine air, then it is very, very dangerous coal mine in terms of coal dust explosion, dangerously dusty. If it contains 100 to 120 gram of coal dust per cubic meter of mine air, and most violent explosion occur if the coal dust is present in the range of 300 to 400 gram per cubic meter of mine air. Okay, so the thermal ignitability curve for a coal dust, showing the relationship between the ignition temperature and the coal dust concentration. In the previous class, we have shown you a graph on the x-axis and y-axis between the ignition temperature and coal dust concentration, so that minimum value of ignition temperature approaches asymptotically at the higher dust concentrations. So this is the volatile matter content. In the coal dust cloud, how much volatile matter is present can be estimated by using this formula. Percentage of volatile matter is equal to percentage of volatile matter from the analysis of the air sample multiplied by 100 divided by 100 minus percentage of ash and percentage of moisture. So the flammability increases with increasing combustible volatile content. If in the coal dust cloud the volatile matter present is more, so it increases the combustible volatile content. And the volatile matter is usually calculated on dry basis, ash free basis, by the formula percentage volatile matter is equal to percentage of volatile matter from the analysis of the air sample multiplied by 100 divided by 100 minus percentage of ash content percentage of moisture in the mine atmosphere. Right hand side of above formula may be written as percentage of volatile matter divided by percentage of volatile matter plus percentage of fixed carbon. Okay, so known as volatile combustible ratio or simply volatile ratio of coal. So here, if the volatile matter is less than 10%, suppose from the experiments you found that the coal dust with volatile matter less than 10%, it is non-inflammable. If the coal dust air mixture contains volatile matter less than 10%, then it is not inflammable. It cannot be ignited. So there is no question of ignition. There is no question of explosion. But if the volatile matter is present in the range of 10 to 14% in the coal dust air mixture, then it is less inflammable. If the volatile matter range lies between 10 to 14%, it is less inflammable. If the volatile matter present in the coal dust air mixture is greater than 14%, it is highly inflammable. It is highly inflammable. So, what do you know by percentage of ash? You know that coal contains ash. In India, the Indian coal contains large amount of ash in the coal. Maybe 30% to 40% ash is there in the coal. So if percentage of ash is more, means it is not going to ignite so easily. So increase in ash content or presence of inert foreign material like your dust particles, stone dust particles, reduces the ignitability and flammability of coal dust because of heat of absorption. So if there is ash present in the coal, if there is ash present in the coal dust cloud, so it will absorb the heat. As a result, the dust is not going to be ignited so easily. Therefore, you use the stone dusts. Stone dusts are inert dusts which are used in the coal mines to neutralize the coal dust explosion. So stone dusting in coal mines functions on this principle, which is a practical application of the use of inert dust to prevent an explosion from taking place. To prevent coal dust explosion to take place in your mines, you have to use the stone dust so that explosions can be arrested in the mines. To control the coal dust explosion, you have to use the stone dust in your mine so that it will neutralize the coal dust. Okay, then what do you mean by percentage of moisture in the coal dust cloud? How much percentage of moisture is there? So moisture in dust particles, if present, it raises the ignition temperature of the dust. You know that moisture is nothing but water particles. H2O, moisture is nothing but water particles. So if, and you know that the fire and water, they repel each other. Fire and water, fire is extinguished by the help of the water. So therefore, if in the coal dust cloud, lot of moisture is there, so ignition is not going to take place. Moisture in dust particles raises the ignition temperature of the dust. And also it exerts a cooling effect. So it will cool down the ignition temperature. It exerts a cooling effect because heat is absorbed during its heating and vaporization, thereby reducing the energy available for ignition of the coal dust cloud. So therefore, coal dust containing 25 to 30% moisture tends to become wet. So if in the coal dust cloud mixture 25 to 30% moisture is there, means it is a wet dust. It is a wet dust. So ignition is not going to take place, and they may also try to agglomerate the fine particles. If moisture is there, there will be agglomeration. Fine particles will be agglomerated and they will reduce the dispersibility of the coal dust. They will reduce the dispersibility of the coal. And if the coal dust is not dispersed, there will be no explosion. Therefore, effect of moisture on flammability is unimportant, below 10%. Effect of moisture on flammability is unimportant, below 10%. If the moisture is 10%, less than 10% in the dust cloud, so it is not, flammability is not going to be affected. But if the moisture content is 25% to 35%, then it will not allow the dust particles to get dispersed in the mine atmosphere, and they will tend to agglomerate the fine particles. As a result, the coal dust cloud will become less susceptible to explosion. Explosion is not going to take place if the dust particles contain 25 to 35% moisture. But if the dust particles contain less than 10% moisture content, then flammability is not going to be affected. Then what is the oxygen concentration in the mine atmosphere? That is very important. We have seen that in the explosion pentagon, 5 parameters are necessary for the explosion to take place. Oxygen is one of them. So variation in oxygen concentration affect the ease of ignition of dust clouds, and the explosion pressure will be developed. With decrease in oxygen concentration, the ignition energy required increases. Igniting temperature also increases, and maximum explosion pressure decreases. As a result, it becomes ineffective. Explosion becomes ineffective with decreasing oxygen concentration. If oxygen is not sufficiently present in the mine atmosphere, so the ignition energy required will be more. Ignition temperature also increases, and maximum explosion pressure decreases. As a result, the explosion does not take place, or it is not very violent explosion. Then, what is the nature and intensity of ignition source? We have seen the different sources of ignition. electricity is one source of ignition, explosives are another source of ignition. So what are the nature and intensity of igniting source? The nature and intensity of ignition source depends on the temperature, size of spark or flame. What is the size of the spark? What is the size of the flame? It will exert a great influence on the flammability of mine dust mixture, as they determine the dust raising capacity and turbulence induced within the cloud. Okay, so the dust particles should, if they are in steel or if they are fixed in layers, so there should be turbulence. Then only there will be dispersion of the dust particles and explosion is going to take place. So explosions initiated by strong sources develop faster and cause more damage than explosions initiated by weak sources. Whether it is a strong source or weak source, ignition source should be very strong. Then only explosion is going to take place. Then presence of fire damp in the mine air. So coal dust is there, coal dust air mixture is there. In the mixture, if methane is present, what will happen? The flammability of coal dust increases almost directly in proportion to the percentage of fire damp. If methane percentage is more in the mine atmosphere in the coal dust air mixture, so the flammability also increases directly with the percentage of fire damp. Presence of fire damp in the mine air in percentage less than its lower limit reduces the lower explosive limit of the coal dust. If the presence of fire damp percentage in the mine is less than 5%, then the explosive limit of coal dust also reduces. And if 1% methane by volume in 1 cubic meter of mine air is equivalent to 12 gram of coal dust, 1% of methane in 1 cubic meter of mine air is equivalent to 12 gram of coal dust. Okay, so what is turbulence? The rate of combustion reaction depends on how intimately dust and oxygen are mixed. How intimately coal dust particles and oxygen are mixed. Turbulent mixing of dust and air result in most violent explosion. If there is turbulence is present, there will be more explosion. Violent explosion will take place. Then what is the surrounding condition? Surrounding condition, like your size of the gallery where the explosion is going to take place, size of the mine gallery, shape of the gallery, whether it's a round shape or rectangular shape, constrictions, obstructions in the mine roadway, branching of the mine roadway, length and nature and condition of the surfaces of mine workings, they will exert an important influence on the coal dust explosions as they increase or decrease the progress of the flame by holding or by releasing the pressure. So these are the surrounding conditions responsible for the coal dust explosion to propagate from one area to other area. So this is all about today's class. Tomorrow we'll discuss about causes of coal dust explosion in mines. What are the various causes of coal dust explosions in mines? Tomorrow we are going to discuss about it. So today we have discussed about coal dust explosion. What is the mechanism of coal dust explosion? What are the factors affecting coal dust explosions? You should go through about it. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Thank you, sir.
Thank you.
Thanks.
See
thank
you sir. Tomorrow. Tomorrow 1:15.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir. Thank you, sir.